Here we go, Fury MMA, the road to Fury, bout number one. 3 2-minute rounds in the featherweight boxing division. Out of the red corner, Mr. Danny Wright versus his blue corner opponent, Hassan Abdi.
Both of them are feeling each other out right now. I must say, Danny Wright came out looking ready to go. What I hear good things about Hassan will be interesting. Oh, good right.
Beautiful connection here early from both fighters. Chris Hookster here with Garth Harriman, live from Greenwich, London.
Both of them popping a few jabs out there. They're showing some good skills so far, aren't they?
Yeah, very disciplined approach so far. Displayed with the straight punching game from both fighters. Red looking to circle and counter here as Danny continues left.
Oh, good right from Danny there.
Excellent connection there, and a stiff jab also. Garth, he seems to have established a distance as he comes in with that 1-2-3 combination very nicely.
Yeah, it's good when you see a fighter find that distance, get his confidence suddenly build up just like this. It's soaring, isn't it?
And Hassan Abdi in trouble here very early at Fury. Beautiful straight jab down the pipe, right hand connecting down low. He's mixing up very well, isn't he, Garth?
Yeah, it's good to see that. I hate seeing fighters when they just jab all the time or just stick with one technique. But to see him mix it up, that's what you want. And it works good on your opponent too. If you're working someone's body, then it tends to make him cover up down low, and then you can clear a path for their head if you want to mix up shots like that. They seem to have slowed down a bit now, though.
Yeah, Hassan's starting to move his head a bit, starting to become a bit more wise to the attack of his opponent, Danny Wright. Danny's still circling the right. He's got to be careful if Hassan starts to use that right hand, don't you think?
Yeah, it's not a good direction to turn if you to follow if you against an opponent who has a good solid right like that. Magnificent.
Lovely connection there. Slipping and returning with the two. That's a very textbook combination. Nearly the end of the round here.
Yeah, if I was the right corner, I'd just be saying, just circle to the right, not the left, and just stay away from your opponent's right hand.
Beautiful, beautiful first round here to start us off with Fury.
Yes.
Both fighters exchanging. How do you have it?
I'd probably just give it to Danny because he had that flurry, but he seemed to slow down after that. I'm not sure if he tied himself out or if he just thought he'd see what results would come of it, but...
That one to three. Another 2 minutes here in the featherweight division. Bout number one, Fury, road to Fury. Chris Hookster with Garth Harriman once again. Beautiful left hook right away from Danny. He's moving his head even better this round, it looks, Garth.
Yeah, he He's still circling to the right, though. He wants to be careful of that.
Yeah, it was difficult to hear with the music, the advice given by both corners. Abdi got his chin up a little bit. He's got to be very careful with those straight shots coming in from his opponent, Wright, but cutting the corner nicely. It is worth noting, Garth, that we're having boxing, but in an MMA cage.
Yeah, cage boxing. This is quite good, actually. I've been to some events where they have some amateur guys coming in to box inside a cage, and it's a bit scrappy and a bit messy, but these guys are showing good techniques. The first round was full of great jabs and combos, and they're continuing on now. That's Wright throwing a good one, too.
Yeah, both fighters connecting very nicely with a disciplined approach, really. And it's nice technique to see for our audience here. Lovely stiff jab, slipping down to the right there by Danny. And then it goes in for the body. Nice.
That was a nice right.
That hurt Abdi, I think. Abdi a bit urgent there to back him off.
Yeah. Ref breaks him up.
But Danny Wright breathing very hard here. But his hands are still good. It's the moment those shoulders get tired that you start to see those hands droop.
Yeah, sometimes it comes on quick, sometimes it comes on later in a fight. A little jab to the chin.
I like that shovel hook from Abdi going up, kind of like an uppercut half.
Yeah, he seems to be coming back a bit this round, doesn't he?
Yeah, just like in round one, really. The same story with Danny establishing himself early, but Abdi making some good necessary adjustments.
Yeah, I'm not judging, of course, but I feel like Wright did enough in the first round. I scored a 10-9 to him. But this one's a bit of a trickier round to score. Probably give it to Abdi.
Yeah, I'd have to agree. Whereas Wright may have taken the first 30 seconds, Abdi coming back very nicely. I think we've got a fight in our hands, Garth.
Yeah, I think it's a round of play. It'll be interesting to see what happens in the next round, see if there's any game changes or any like we were saying before. I mean, this is an amateur fight, but they're showing some great skills. You can tell they've been trained well. They're not afraid to mix it up. Like, look at those. Wright's going for it again at the start of the round.
Absolutely sick fluid movement from both fighters. Wonderful display. I like how he rolls underneath those hooks and comes up with a left hook. Danny Wright looking very nice early, but will Abdi adjust as we've seen the last two rounds?
Yeah, they're getting in some pretty decent flurries. Photographers must be loving this because they'd be getting some good shots of they're both going for it at the same time.
And doing it technically correct, as we've said. You know, the way they throw the hooks, the way they slip, the way they bob and weave, it's just a beautiful display of martial arts that we see from young, up-and-coming fighters. And I think really sets the tone for what Road to Fury is all about.
Yeah. It's up-and-coming guys, but they're guys who have trained well and have good camps and good coaches. Wright's doing some good body shots to Abdi there as well. He's mixing up really well.
He's avoiding more damage to this round, I would say, Garth.
Yeah, he might be slowing down again. He comes out flying at the start of the rounds and then tends to slow down a bit. At least that's what's happened with the last two.
Especially when Habidi's able to clinch and cut the cage. Again, you know, it is slightly different. Whereas in a boxing ring, you've got corners to work off the ropes. Here, it's a bit more of a circular experience.
Yeah, it makes things a little bit different, doesn't it?
Beautiful left and right to the body. Habidi doing wise to come upstairs and slip away, though.
Yeah, Wright gives him some to the body, and Abdi returns it to his face.
Very nice. Abdi closing the distance there, wise to that rolling and then left hook attack from his opponent, Danny Wright.
Yeah, Habidi's got the more consistent cardio. But the advantage of this is, 10 seconds to go now, I was going to say that at least Wright knows this is the final round. He can really go all out. And they both seem to be doing that.
Absolutely brilliant effort from both fighters. Danny Wright and Hassan Abdi going at it. Fury MMA.
Again, a difficult round to score, though. They both kind of came away on either side. We'll see what the judges give it to. Who the judges give it to, I should say.
And two of your judges here at ringside have scored the bout for your winner from the blue corner, fighting out of Lion's Den MMA.